What's up, everybody? It's Friday. Just got out of work. It's nice and overcast. We out here at Lake Murray. We're going to try to catch some stripers. And if we're lucky enough to catch a keeper, we're going to do a little catch, clean, and cook on the beach. I brought a little portable stove, a little onion, and we'll see if we can cook dinner. But like I said, it's overcast. They should bite. So stay tuned. Cut that motor off, raise it up, first thing we're going to do is fillet this fish up. I'm only going to do one half of it, or one side of it for right now. You guys know how to clean a fish. But if you don't, here's your tutorial. Need a sharp knife, which I don't know if this one is. But we can check it out. Yep, pretty sharp. Roll it right there. Cut it down there. Whew. These fish are gorging themselves. Run it down the backbone. Go all the way to, all the way through, I mean. Actually bled this fish out. I don't know if it works. A lot of offshore people do it. They'll basically euthanize the fish. So I took a knife and put it in its, basically its brain, and put it out of its misery so it wouldn't suffer. Nice little fillet right there. I guess I'll go ahead and do this other side while we're here. And but no, basically you're puncturing the heart. Letting all the blood pop out, or pour out, excuse me. Which, I don't know. Striper got kind of a strong bloodline. So, it may work, it may not. I don't know. I'm just trying it. Run that down there. Get to there. Keep it on the backbone. Through them pin bones, or the rib bones, I call them pin bones. And there you go, got two fillets. I actually poked their eyes out. Obviously they're dead, they can't feel it. But I poked their eyes out, and that'll make it, when you throw it in the water, it'll make it sink. And that thing will be gone by this, ooh, gross. I don't know what that is, that's nasty. It'll be gone by tomorrow. Turtles and catfish and whatever else. Let me clean this up for a second and we'll get the grill. Right, well, actually, I gotta take the skin off these, so let me do that real quick. Best thing to do, get your knife. With these, you don't want to run it right down the skin. Try to leave some of that blood on there. So that's the reason why I don't necessarily have to have a super flimsy knife for this. I actually like a little bit of a stiffer knife. That way I can run a little bit off the skin. It's not bad. Got a little bit of blood there. We'll cut that off. Put it on that pan. Just bring it back. Yo, I don't know what this green stuff is. It's either eggs or poop. But neither one of them sound appetizing. So I'm gonna get rid of that. It's pretty disgusting. So, cut. There, stay. Yep. Perfect. Probably a good enough dinner for two, but it's just me today, so I'm gonna clean this up. Portion it up. I got an onion too I'm going to dice up, and then we'll get to cooking. Alright, check out what we got here. This little stove is pretty nifty. You got the little butane locked in there. Give it a little click. Oh yeah. It's going. She's rolling. Alright, so we got some onions. Got a little bit of extra virgin olive oil. And we got a little bit of Kinder's The Blend, salt, pepper, and garlic. Delicious. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to get this olive oil open. And we're going to spread it all over here. And we're going cook our onions first. So we got the olive oil, we got some of the seasoning, put it all over there. Onions is one of those things I hate raw. Hate them. Can't stand the smell, can't stand the taste of raw onions. But for some reason, when you cook them up, they're delicious. So, it don't take long for that thing to heat up. So what we'll do is we'll cook the onions first. It's already starting to sizzle. Can you smell it? So I'm gonna cook these up. Man, they already smelling good. Saute them up. And once they're done, we'll take those off and cook the fish. It won't take long. The fish, I bet, won't take but 3 minutes aside. You know, I'm just standing here in the water. Excuse the onion peels. I'm standing here in the water. My shoes smelt awful. So, they're getting a little bad at night. I don't know if my shoes or my feet, but one of the two. So, God, it smells good. So this is a pretty healthy meal. It's gonna be fish and onions, and that's it. I was gonna bring some bread, but you don't get a body like this eating all those carbs. So we'll let these cook down for about 5 or 10 minutes, take them off, and then we're gonna throw on the fish, and it'll be dinner time. To tell y'all, Jighead Jr.'s down at the beach with Mama and Ellie Hayes, so Daddy's flying solo, so he plans to do a lot of fishing over the next couple days. They're coming back Saturday, so I might try to do another video, but man, it's smelling good. Oh, good. Think this through. I hope I brought a fork. Oh, I did bring a spatula. I don't know why am I using this knife. Alright, instead of being a dummy trying to pick that pan up, I'm gonna just scoop it out. Smelling good. wasn't exactly sure where it went, so I had to improvise with a toaster oven pan. And I don't think it's made to withstand this direct heat. But, oh well. Use what we got. Fish. We got us some onion. See how it tastes. That ain't no joke. People say they don't like striper. Probably didn't cut the bloodline out. Or just, I mean, it is definitely a stronger taste than fish. One more fish. So I'm going to try to scarf this down, clean the boat up real quick, and try to catch one more fish before we head back to the house. Stay tuned.
You know what?
I said I was going to go try to catch some more fish. I don't think I am. I think I'm going to enjoy this meal and just sit out here and enjoy the beautiful weather. Sorry there wasn't very much fishing action today. Caught probably 12 or 15 fish, but I didn't have the GoPro on some of them just because I don't have a ton of battery left, so I just want to make sure we got the cook part down. But hopefully we got a few of them on camera. But I appreciate you joining us. You guys have a happy Easter, and we'll catch you on the next one.